hair. I'm kind of nervous. I think I have orange hair. I've never done color in my life.
We're hoping to catch this before the rain. Okay, it's raining.
I can't wait to be like not wearing clothes.
Oh
yes.
Hey.
Hey.
Oh. Yeah, so hi everyone, my name is Aiyana Ishmael. I am a senior at Florida A&M University and I'm a journalism student. So that's a little bit about me. I'm from Miami, Florida. So today is my graduation shoot. I'm extremely stressed out, overwhelmed, but I'm excited nonetheless. The weather has been kind of crazy, so that's kind of been throwing me off all week, but it's looking like it might be okay. But either way, I had a plan, like B, C, all of that prepared. So I'm not too worried, just ready to get the day rolling. Yeah, so we have a jam-packed day. I have a hair appointment at 10 a.m. I decided I wanted to do a fun album cover just because one of my favorite artists, like I just love her album. So I was like, let me do this. And so we have that shoot, like my hair at 10. I'm doing my own makeup for that because I was like, I'm a little broke. We can't do two makeup appointments in one day. So after that, we'll go to the shoot around noon. And then I think I have like an hour break. And then I go straight into my second hair appointment where I'm getting my hair done again to go to a normal style because the hair I'm getting for the first time is a little crazy. And then we have our makeup appointment and then our shoot. So it's gonna be a busy day. So the album cover is Hot Pink from Doja Cat. She's my favorite artist in the world, like love her to pieces. And that album honestly got me through quarantine and the pandemic. So I'm excited. I'm hoping it turns out good. Well, it's gonna turn out good. So that's how we're gonna speak it into existence. Oh my gosh, she's an icon. I think I personally have been a fan of her since I think I was in high school when her song like So High came out. Like I've been like an OG Doja Cat fan, but I remember she went viral like doing when her song Moo came out. Like that was like, if you look at that album that Moo comes from, it literally is like the only silly song she has on there and everything else is amazing. But people are like, oh my God, this girl's crazy. But I personally kind of just relate to her. I think she's cool, she's unique, she's different. She's not one to follow all the rules, and like she doesn't care what anyone says about her, and that's kind of how I see myself. And she's just like lyrically amazing. I think all of her songs are so good. String Kiss Me More with her featuring SZA is so fire, but she's just one of my fave artists. Like I don't have many artists that I like rep all day long, but she's one of them. She has on, so that'll be fun. But then for the regular graduation shoot, I have my J School outfit, which is just a mauve, which is like a pinkish suit. And then I have another cute outfit that's like white and gold. It's like button up with a cute little like peplum skirt. And then I also have, I have a black dress with like low cut and then like slits. And then I have a huge, super huge princess green, hunter green dress that is, it's large. It's like 8 pounds when they shipped it.
Shipped it from where?
New Jersey. So I have a friend that I met at a journalism conference and he's a designer. So I was like, let's play around, let's have something fun. I want to be extravagant. I've never done a big photo shoot. So I was like, let's just go all out, whatever. I don't want to see any negativity into it, but the weather, because my mom is like really persistent in me getting a photo in my green princess dress on the rattlesnake. And I told her, if it's raining, what am I gonna do? And she was like, I don't care. You're like, you just get wet. And I'm like, okay. So I would prefer not to have to get rained on. But I mean, if like that's what happens, then that's what happens. But I'm just hoping that the weather cooperates. I know how to move fast. Like that's what I do with Journey. I was editor in chief. Like all we did was photo shoots. So I'm used to kind of having to make things work. But the weather is the biggest obstacle just because it is like, it's hard to like get around, especially on FAMU's campus. Nothing is covered. So like, even if I want to turn a flame shot, I'm gonna have to get like wet. So it's like, we'll figure that out as we go. I'm just gonna pray for good vibes. It's a little crazy, but I'm obsessed. It's like low cut in the front, and then it's gonna pepper out.
Yes.
Oh, hello.
Okay, so. Let's do it. It's not focus traps. It's more creative, you know?
Yeah, but they ain't looking at
it. Bye. I'm excited to graduate. I think I've kind of been like over school for a while now, especially when the pandemic started. So I'm excited to like go into the real world and, you know, start a new chapter. I keep saying I start a new book. I'm not starting a new chapter, I'm starting a new book, because I just think, you know, this next journey is gonna be so different than like what being a student is like. So I'm just ready for the real world. I know people are like, oh, I never wanna leave college, but I'm like, it's expired. My time has expired here. I think I've done everything that I wanted to do, and if I didn't do everything I wanted to do, it wasn't meant to happen. So it's more so just like, let's go, let's move on, next phase of our life, and let's live it up.
You did a good job, though.
All right, I'll see you again.
I'll see you later. Thank you. Your services are very appreciated.
Yeah.
You're so fun. I'm so like tempted to post like a selfie right now, but I just like, no. Too many people see it. Feeling good. First shoot done. This one was a little, as you can tell, I was super like nervous the entire time because obviously I was like half naked and I have orange hair. Two things I don't normally do, but we're all about like graduating, starting a new book, and we're starting a new experience with who Aiyana is. So I love doing fun stuff like this. I just never want, like, would ever see myself doing it. So it was fun to get out of my comfort zone, and I'm excited for like the really pretty stuff tonight because my makeup's gonna be professionally done. And the dress is gorgeous, so I'm excited.
So yeah, you just got here?
Yeah.
Talk a little bit about that.
So we've been running all day. As you can tell, the dress is a lot, but I was at my makeup appointment, just finished up, so me and my friends, and my roommates too, we just rushed here, trying to get here on time. We're hoping to catch this before the rain. Okay, it's raining.
Here you go.
Hello.
Hey.
That's life, but I mean, rain is a good
sign.
It's
a
good time. I read it online. It says it's like the beginning of like a new chapter. It like means a fresh start. So. That's always fun.
I'm Marissa Stubbs, and I met Aiyana during my sophomore year. She was a transfer student, and I was a sophomore. And yeah, we kind of bonded over just writing. She wrote for Journey during that time, so yeah.
I'm Madeline Smith, and I know Aiyana because she is my roommate. When I first transferred to FAMU, she was the, like, one of the first people that I met. So yeah, and today's going pretty good. Well, actually, it was not, because it's raining. But she looks good. She looks very good. She did what she was supposed to do, but the weather did not hold up. But hopefully, we'll figure it out. She's very creative, so I think we got it.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, if you just pull up, because you have the umbrella. So if you just pull it close enough, I'll just put it over. Because the thing is that I don't care about the dress getting wet after you take photos.
I'm the bestie. My name is Mia. Aiyana and I met freshman year of high school. We were the only two black girls in our drama class. And I sat next to her and I said, you're the only black girl, so we're gonna be friends. And it's been like that since. So that's my bestie for the restie.
Ooh, this is a tough one. Oh, I honestly just have to say homecoming, like that 2 week in that fall of 2018 when like, I was super busy like with homecoming because I was in J school, so we do the homecoming special, and so I literally got to go to everything. And for me, I love journalism, especially being at FAMU, because I got to be involved with everything without having to actually like, be involved with everything. I got to like literally be backstage at all the step shows, the housing, Greek. I got to go to everything and like just record it and be a part of the whole experience. So it was nice. And then I got to like interview, what are their names? The people from the 85 South show. I got to talk to them backstage because we were press. And so getting those experiences, that whole week was amazing. And then literally the next week, a hurricane hit.
Sit tight. Here we go,
Mark.
My experience was so much fun. I was a transfer student, so I always say like I got here late, but you know, like right on time. But it was just, I think it was fun. Like I did a lot of different cool things that I got to be a part of, especially within J school. I just did so much within J school. And then just also being involved with war, that was a lot of fun just because advocacy programs are so important to me. So being able to do a lot of J school cool fun things, and then also just meeting people. I think, especially my first year was fall of 2018. So that was like my first homecoming experience. And that homecoming was really fun. So I was like, I've had a great time, honestly. Like I got to go to Classic before the pandemic hit. So it was nice to get to do like all the traditional stuff before the pandemic kind of changed our schooling.
I love it.
It's the power pose for me. It's the power pose for me.
Hey.
You on fire.
It's helping. I'll probably be going back to Miami for a little while. I have to figure out just financially what I want to do. I start with the Wall Street Journal in June. So it's fully remote over the summer, but they're looking to start opening newsrooms come July. And then I also just signed a contract for like a part-time culture writing gig with this magazine called Gradzilla. So I already have like things in New York City, so I'm just trying to like play it by ear because I want the cheapest rent. New York is so expensive, so I don't want to pay more than like $1,300 if I can fight it. Like I want to live in Harlem or Brooklyn. So I've kind of just been talking to friends that are already up there, seeing what's available because COVID rent is super cheap. So I'm trying to see if it's smarter for me to move now when the rent's cheaper, or will it still be cheap come like November when rent is always cheap in New York City. So today was crazy, to say the least. I think it went well, surprising with all the weather. You know, we had a lot of crazy things happen, but overall, it's like exactly like my life, so I think I'm kind of happy with it. I think I'm always on the go, and I still always get the shot, even if things aren't exactly how I imagine. Life isn't how I always imagine it. That's the number one thing I always say. Transfer student, community college grad, like life was never gonna be a perfect path. So just today was a great reminder, you know, to be happy that I'm alive and getting to take pretty pictures and celebrate the fact that I am graduating from a historically Black university. So I'm excited.